Two of her books focus on feminism, this being the second one, and Remarkable Women. In 1975, she had this book called The Power Lovers. She came out to interview my wife. I was a freshman congressman. When I read the book, I thought, oh my God, I will never get reelected. Because she quoted my wife exactly, in which she said, and I paraphrase here, there was some reference to my scrotum, and then she said, in my room, this is where she said, my God, my life would be horribly depressing if all I had to live for was my husband being in Congress.
And I was so concerned that Nobby would show up, and I'm certainly glad the weather did get in the way. We're all here for literature, we're here for punctuation and syntax, but we're here because we love Nobby McPherson. But nobody, but no one loves her more than her only son, in whom she is well pleased, Michael Siegel.
My thought for the book and the title was the She-Wolves of Wall Street. But everybody's wearing a boa here, and I have no idea what the hell they'd be wearing if we came up with that one. So, Mom, thank you for rejecting that. I would certainly say that one of the proudest, all of the proudest moments I have when people ask, so your mom from Myra McPherson? It's a very simple yes. May very well be your last book. I doubt it, but it could. All right. I want to read one review that none of you will ever read. Myra McPherson sets the gold standard in both her professional and her personal life. She's selfless, a humble talent, of remarkable insight and integrity, a wonderful and loving grandmother and mother, adored by her son and her grandchildren. And with that, I am done to introduce the woman of the evening, my mom.
This is my Oscar without the golden statue. I really have lots of people to thank. Among them are the women who crawled up to the second floor here, which we were not allowed to do until 1980-something. And I might add that when they did come forth with the idea that maybe women could be here and even be members, it was not this great egalitarian move, it was because they were afraid of losing their liquor license. I didn't have great fun writing, but I had great fun researching. And as we always say, we only write the book for the party.
So you might say, when did we first meet? Well, here it is, right here, folks. July the 15th, 1970, Myra McPherson's story about me in the style section. July 15th, 1970. And it was about my discovery of the tiger cages. But I loved her last little line. She said, I got fired from my job. And I was told I'd never work again in Congress. So Myra asked me about that. And here's what she said. He said he hasn't had any job offers. Adding with a smile, no one wants to hire anyone who's going to tell on them. That was her last line. And since then, we have been close friends. So I'm here basically to just thank Myra for her longtime friendship with me. I can't believe it's been 44 years, Myra.
Oh, God.
We were young.
I was 12.
Oh, we were young. Of course, she had had a thing with JFK before me. Should I go into that?
No.
Well, okay. So here's this young, vivacious, attractive, personally magnetic young woman who gets to interview JFK. Now here's how rumors get started. So I'm about to start a rumor. It's been rumored that maybe the interaction didn't just stop with the interview now that we know more about JFK. But I'm looking forward to this book. the Scarlet sisters. We were having lunch, my wife Ruth, and Myra and I were having lunch, and she was telling us about this book. And my wife, who is a great feminist, as you can imagine, and crazy feminist, and so my wife said, "Who are these people? I never heard of Woodhull and Kaplan, is that her name? Never heard of them." And I'll never forget, Myra said, "Ruth, they're your forebears. What you're talking about now, they did back in the 1870s. So I'm looking forward to reading it. And so I'm just here again to thank Myra for all of her books, for all of the writing she's done outside of the books, but all of her columns. And to thank Myra for one thing in particular. Now listen to this, folks. I want to thank Myra for one thing particularly. For always keeping the faith for women's superiority.